Okay, so today we have the White Stripes and Hotel Yorba, and apparently, and we're gonna watch the video too, but apparently this was the first music video the band ever did. So that's very obviously historic, I guess I might say. So anyway, let's get into this, talk about it after. I am a fan of the White Stripes, I am a fan of Jack White, but this is a song, and I know it's one of their most famous ones, but I've never really, my God, never really listened to it, never really gave it a chance. I don't know, it's just that's how things go, I guess, and it's only like 2 minutes long, but finally come to Hotel Yorba. Let's go. Let's talk about it after. My goodness.
It might sound silly for me to think childish thoughts like these, but I'm so tired of acting tough and I'm gonna do what I please. Let's get married in a big cathedral by a priest. 'Cause if I'm the man that you love the most, you can say I do at least. Well, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, take the elevator at the Hotel Yorba. I'll be glad to see you later.
It is the White Stripes and Hotel Yorba. My God, still getting over a cold here. Anyway, I have to say, just with the ending of that video, just with the kind of simplicity of the video as well, with this being their first video, I just love how much fun they seem to be having. I just love at one part there with Meg kind of being, strapped to Jack or whatever with the rope, and just the imagery is kind of funny. And then at the end there too. And Meg is, of course, on the bed, and Jack's sitting on the edge of the bed, basically, and she's laughing. Kind of, has her drumsticks drumming on a almost like a cabinet or, some kind of wooden thing. Anyway, it's just very intriguing. And yeah, but I just love how they seem to be having so much fun. Meg's laughing, like I said, Jack's flashing a smile. And I like the little looks that Jack would give throughout the video, too. He was just, I don't know, he's such a. Charming character, I have to say. So anyway, I like that a lot. I like the video, and it's just so kind of quirky. I guess that's the word I want to use for this. And I mean, my God, the song is so jumpy. It's so lively. It's so boisterous, you might say too. And again, it's just 2 minutes 15 seconds long, and just the whole 1, 2, 3, 4, da 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 da, whatever. I think of course the Ramones. I think of diddy Ramone when he always would say 1, 2, 3, 4. And when you hear 1, 2, 3, 4, I feel like that's almost like a warning of what you're about to hear is going to be very catchy. You're going to start dancing around, kind of a thing. And it's kind of like a like I said, kind of a way to show that you're about to get into a song. That's really good, and that's really catchy, and it's an earworm. And that's no exception on this one. And with this, whole Hotel Yorba, reading up on Hotel Yorba and seeing that it's a real hotel in Detroit. Of course, Jack grew up there. I would say Meg, I think, grew up there as well. Anyway, and Jack, it almost sounds like Jack White was just kind of, I guess, in your town, whatever city you live in, there's buildings that you're kind of fascinated by. You've heard stories. And there is a story here that I read on Jack White, I guess, on his website. It said that it was on his website anyway. But anyway, where Jack heard that the Beatles stayed at Hotel Yorba, but it ended up being a false rumor anyway, but that he's always loved that rumor either way. And that, I guess, some rock stars have stayed at Hotel Yorba. Of course, the hotel, I think, is closed down now. Closed down, from what I'm seeing on Wikipedia, closed down in 2013. But, again, it's just those I guess, hotels, those buildings in your city that you're kind of fascinated by just because you've heard stories, whatever, weird stories, whatever it is, captivating stories. And that's what it seems to be here with Jack White. And this is kind of like, I guess you might say, a couple on a... having an adventurous weekend, a fun weekend, at Hotel Yorba. And then they're talking about how they want to get married. They're taking risks, talking about wanting to get a home. And then they're on that, on the porch of the home there too, stomping their feet, of course. And, it's just, a lot of, a lot of risk taking going on, and talking about, well, let's just get married. Why not? We love each other so much. The least you can say is I do. And again, it's just, I love, the funness of it all, if that's a word. I love how fun it is. I love how, again, lively it is. It wakes you up. I mean, my God, it gets you going. It makes you happy. If this doesn't get you moving, then you're dead. And with the way that Jack is delivering these vocals, I just love, again, because it's kind of a simple setting, whatever. But again, his voice is always kind of intense in a way. And again, there's songs like the song that's in my recommended here, We're Gonna Be Friends, where Jack's voice is not as intense or not as bold. But in this one, again, he's just so intense. He's so powerful. He has such that a distinctive kind of edge to his voice, you would say. And then I loved Meg's drumming, and I have to say again, I like that I'm doing this because I want to talk about Meg's drumming a little bit. And actually, it was just her birthday a few days ago now. Her birthday's in December, I know. But anyway, and her drumming actually came up this year in 2023, where somebody said her drumming sucks. And even though the White Stripes have disbanded, they've been disbanded for like 12 years, but somebody was talking about how they suck, or how her drumming sucks. And it's just like, I know that a lot of people have talked about that. Some people don't like her drumming, and a lot of people do like her drumming. But the whole point, and I think Jack said it before, I forget where he said it, but he talked about how she kind of sounded like a kid on the drums. She wasn't a John Bonham, she wasn't a Keith Moon, whatever, she wasn't a big, she wasn't like that, whatever, with drums. She was just so perfect for the White Stripes. Her bold, brash sound, and again, very bold. She was a hard-hitting drummer. I mean, my God, and that's what really came through on this one, so bold and brash, and it just fits so well for the duo. So I've always just really, I don't know, when people say her drumming sucks, it's just like, yeah, again, she's not, again, a proficient, whatever you, when you think of a drummer, like Neil Peart or whatever, Neil Peart, whatever, but yeah, she was great for the band, and I just have to say that again, I thought she was so unmissable on this track, and so distinctive too in her own way. Again, I just can't say it enough, her drumming was always so hard-hitting, and this one is no exception one more time again. So looking, if I could find the lyrics page here, there we go, on genius.com. So I've said basically everything I wanted to say. Again, just about taking risks, about living your life, adventurous time on the weekend, it seems like, maybe on this at this Hotel Yorba, a hotel that Jack seemed to be fascinated with. So with the first verse, I was watching with one eye on the other side. I had 15 people telling me to move. I got moving on my mind. Again, I just love it. It has that kind of blues country kind of old feel to it, like a country song from the 60s or 50s. As somebody who grew up listening to that time because of my dad. But again, just that whole thing, I got moving on my mind, just the way Jack delivers this, you can tell he's so influenced by old country stars or whatever. But anyway, I found shelter and some thoughts turning wheels around. I said 39 times that I love you to the beauty I had found. And again, talking about how much he loves this person, how much they love each other. And then we go into the chorus, which is just, again, so jumpy. Well, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, take the elevator at the Hotel Yorba. I'll be glad to see you later. And they got inside is vacancy. Because again, I guess this hotel, when you search it up, wasn't a very, wasn't a lavish hotel. It was kind of a shithole. And, but Jack seems to just really adore that. And talking about all they got inside is vacancy because no one's there. Nobody wants to be there. And again, just take the elevator at the Hotel Yorba. So rhythmic, so fast paced. But, and again, just when you read it, you have to read it like and sing it like he did in the song. I've been thinking of a little place down by the lake. They got a dirty road, the dirty old road leading up to the house. And again, it's just this imagery just reminds me of old country again. A dirty old road leading up to the house. I wonder how long it will take till we're alone, sitting on the front porch of that home. And then, again, now talking about these kind of dreams they have, owning this house, or I guess, down by the lake on this dirty old road, sitting on the front porch of that home, stomping our feet on the wooden boards, never going to worry about locking the door. And then when he says never going to worry about locking the door, almost like they're in a place where you know, you don't have to worry about being, I guess, robbed or, you know, killed or something like that. I guess you just leave the door unlocked. Why the hell not? And then we go on with the chorus one more time, which is, again, it's such an earworm. And I mean, you can't have that chorus put in the song too many times, because it's just so good. And it's, you know, you want to hear it more and more. My God. And then we go to the third verse. And it might sound silly for me to think these childish thoughts, but I'm so tired of acting tough. And I'm going to do what I please. So then he says, let's get married. You know, it's just like, I'm going to do what I please. Why not? Let's get married in a big cathedral by a priest. Because if I'm the man that you love the most, you could say I do at least. So again, at this point, it's just like, why not? Let's just get married. Let's take risks. Let's have fun. You love me. I love you. Let's go. And then we have the chorus one more time. And then at the end, and it's 4, 5, 6, 7, you know, going on off of 1, 2, 3, 4. Grab your umbrella. Grab hold of me. Because I'm your favorite fella. All they got inside is vacancy. So again, now I'm feeling like, is there holes in the ceiling, in the roof or whatever? You know, we gotta have an umbrella because it's raining, and it's raining in the side too. and grab hold of me. Talking about, again, grab hold of me. You grab hold of me, I'll grab hold of you. Again, it sounds like they're very protective of each other. Grab that umbrella, and or just grab that umbrella just to talk about life, whatever. We're going to need an umbrella for life and whatever it throws at us, you know, kind of as a metaphor in a way. But again, you know, if all they get inside is vacancy, I think about them going inside the hotel with an umbrella, which again, I think they say is whatever, bad luck, whatever, to have an umbrella inside or open it inside or whatever. But anyway, I just talked about how basically, again, this hotel isn't seen as, you know, a lavish, luxurious place, but at the same time, Jack and Meg seem to be so infatuated by it, and, you know, we're gonna go inside and grab a hold of me, I'll grab a hold of you, and we'll, you know, this love's gonna last forever, and, it's just a beautiful kind of, a beautiful song, a beautiful, you know, a great relatable song if you have somebody, and you feel the same way about, you know, yourselves with each other, whatever. It sounds like a wedding song in a way. I can't say what I want to say. You know, this sounds like a great wedding song, a song that if you love somebody, I can imagine, you know, listening to the song and thinking about that other person that you love, and just kind of the relatability here. My goodness, grabbing a hold of them and going to a place like a Hotel Yorba, whatever, getting married, hoping for that home one day that you're going to love, and be able to leave the doors unlocked because nobody's around, and nobody bad is around anyway. So yeah, I just really enjoyed this song, I have to say, for, you know, 2 minutes, 15 seconds, so lively, so fun, and the video too, I love it. And again, the black, white, and red that they always wore, just how, you know, Meg was always kind of the quiet one, of course, and Jack was, you know, at the forefront, but Meg's sound was never, you know, behind, it was always right there too at the forefront. She was obviously kind of the heartbeat of the band, and while Jack was on guitar, you know, such a great guitarist, I mean, one of the greatest guitarists of his age and of today, you know, that's alive, I mean, my God. So anyway, love it so much. And again, I just hate that, you know, they had to split basically because of Meg's, you know, anxiety and stuff like that. But again, her health comes before, you know, performing. And of course, Jack's gone on to have a great solo career as well. So anyway, all that said, the song was only like 2 minutes, and I don't know how long I've been blabbing on. But thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting, all that stuff. Thanks for the requests for more kind of garage rock too. Again, I haven't done a video in a while because I've been sick for the last week and a half. But I'm glad to finally come back and listen to a song here from the White Stripes. So again, thanks for everything. I'll talk to you guys again soon.